नमो नमः। दीपावल्याः अवकाशात् अनन्तरं सर्वेषां छात्राणां पुनरेकवारं हार्दं स्वागतम्। सर्वे छात्राः कुशलिनः स्वस्थाः च सन्ति इति अहं मन्ये। प्रियच्छात्राः, अद्यतनतासिकायाः विषयः अस्ति संख्यावाचकाः शब्दाः। एकतः पञ्चाशत् पर्यन्तं संख्यानां विषये अस्यां तासिकायां चर्चा भविष्यति। Yes, students, the topic chosen for today's session is संख्यावाचकाः शब्दाः। I know that you have already got acquainted with the concept of number names in Sanskrit, and you may find it a very easy and simple topic to deal with. But sometimes it can be tricky as well. So let's spend a little more time on understanding the संख्यावाचकाः शब्दाः and their forms. So let's get started with the topic. In Sanskrit, numbers are used as adjectives and they are called संख्यावाचकानि विशेषणानि. And we should know that the forms of 1, 2, 3 and 4 are different in all the three genders. It means these संख्यावाचकानि विशेषणानि change their forms as per the gender of the qualified noun. But from 5 onwards, they are similar in all the three genders. It means they never change their forms as per the gender of the qualified noun. Let's try to understand it with the help of some examples.
Ekah vrukshah, eka shakha, ekam phalam. One tree, one branch, one fruit. Dvau vrukshau, dve shakhe, dve phale. Two trees, two branches, two fruits. Trayah vrukshah, tisrah shakhah, trini phalani. Three trees, three branches, three fruits. Chatvarah vrukshah, chatasrah shakhah, chatvari phalani. Four trees, four branches, four fruits. Students, as you can see, the संख्यावाचक विशेषणानि from 1 to 4 vary as per the gender of the qualified noun.
And as I have told you earlier, from 5 onwards, the forms of संख्यावाचकानि विशेषणानि are common in all the three genders. Let's see some examples to understand the concept.
Pancha means 5. पंचवृक्षाः, पंचशाखाः, पंचफलानि. षट् अथवा षड् means 6. षड्वृक्षाः, षट्शाखाः, षट्फलानि. सप्त is 7. सप्तवृक्षाः, सप्तशाखाः, सप्तफलानि. अष्ट means 8. अष्टवृक्षाः, अष्टशाखाः, अष्टफलानि. नव means 9. नववृक्षाः, नवशाखाः, नवफलानि. दश means 10. दशवृक्षाः, दशशाखाः, दशफलानि.
Students, while seeing the examples, we have come across the two forms of the number 6, and they are shat and shad. Now the question is, when to use shat and when to use shad? So let me give you the answer. If you remember, while explaining Sanskrit Varnamala, I have introduced you with the concepts of Kathora Vyanjanani and Mrudu Vyanjanani, that is, hard consonants and soft consonants. So what are the hard consonants? The first two letters of each class and sh, sh and s are known as Kathora Vyanjanani or hard consonants. If the next word is beginning with any one of these Kathora Vyanjanani, then we are supposed to use shat. For example, shat phalani. As you can see, the word phalani is beginning with a hard consonant, so shat is used here. Except these 13 Vyanjanani, rest all are known as mrudu Vyanjanani or soft consonants. So if the next word is beginning with a mrudu vyanjanam or swaraha, that is a vowel, then we are supposed to use shad. For example, shad vrukshaha. The word vrukshaha is beginning with a soft consonant, so shad is used here. I hope the concept is clear to you all. Students, now we are going to see the number names from 1 to 50 in Sanskrit. There is one suggestion. While seeing the number names, observe their spellings carefully. So let's get started.
Ekataha dashaparyantam sankhyavachak shabdaha. Ekaha eka ekam. Dvau द्वे द्वे त्रयः तिस्रः त्रीणि चत्वारः चतस्रः चत्वारि पञ्च षट् सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादशतः विंशतिपर्यन्तं संख्यावाचकशब्दः एकादश द्वादश त्रयोदश चतुर्दश पञ्चदश षोडश सप्तदश अष्टादश नवदश विंशतिः एकविंशतितः त्रिंशत्पर्यन्तं संख्यावाचकशब्दः एकविंशतिः द्वाविंशतिः त्रयोविंशतिः चतुर्विंशतिः पञ्चविंशतिः षड्विंशतिः सप्तविंशतिः अष्टाविंशतिः नवविंशतिः त्रिंशत् एकत्रिंशत्तः चत्वारिंशत् पर्यन्तं संख्यावाचक शब्दाः एकत्रिंशत् द्वात्रिंशत् त्रयस्त्रिंशत् चतुस्त्रिंशत् पञ्चत्रिंशत् षट्त्रिंशत् सप्तत्रिंशत् अष्टात्रिंशत् नवत्रिंशत् चत्वारिंशत् एकचत्वारिंशत्तः पञ्चाशत्पर्यन्तं संख्यावाचकशब्दाः एकचत्वारिंशत् द्विचत्वारिंशत् त्रिचत्वारिंशत् चतुश्चत्वारिंशत् पञ्चचत्वारिंशत् षट्चत्वारिंशत् सप्तचत्वारिंशत् अष्टचत्वारिंशत् नवचत्वारिंशत् पञ्चाशत्
Students, now we are going to see how to make the use of these number names in sentences. As I have told you earlier, in Sanskrit, numbers are used as adjectives, that is, Visheshana Padani. And these adjectives follow the Vishesha Padani, that is, the qualified nouns in lingam, vachanam and vibhaktihi. we have to pay more attention while using the forms of the numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4. Let's see some examples to understand the concept.
Here is the example. Kridangane dash balika khelati. We are supposed to use the proper form of the sankhya 1. The sankhya 1 is the visheshanam of the word balika. Balika is a strilingi shabd. So the answer is kridangane eka balika khelati. Let's see one more example. Dasharathasya dash putraha asan. We are supposed to use the proper form of the sankhya 4. The sankhya 4 is the visheshanam of the word putraha, which is a masculine word, that is pullingi shabdaha. So the answer is Dasharathasya chatvarah putraha asan. Let me take you to one more example. Mahabharate dash parvani santi. In this sentence, the number 18 given in the bracket is the visheshanam of the word parvani. But as we have learned, the number names from 5 onwards have similar forms in all the 3 genders. So, there will be no change in the form of 18. We just have to write the correct spelling of the given sankhya. So, the answer is Mahabharate Ashtadasha Parvani Santi. Let's see one more example. Kakshayam dash chatraha santi. We are supposed to use the proper form of the number 47. 47 is the visheshanam of the word chatraha. And the answer is Kakshayam sapta chatvarimshat chatraha santi. I hope you have understood the concept.
Students, sometimes the question based on sankhyavachakani visheshanani can be tricky. Though the options will be provided for your help, but those options can be confusing. To avoid making mistakes, you should know that the given number is the adjective of which word in the sentence. You should be aware of the lingam, vachanam and vibhaktihi of the qualified noun. And you should also know the correct spelling of the given sankhyavachakam visheshanam. To make the concept clear, let me take you to some examples.
Here is the question. Vrukshe dash khagaha tishthanti. The sankhya given in the bracket is 4. It is the visheshanam of the word khagaha. The 3 options are given for the answer, but to choose the correct option, we should know the gender of the word khagaha. It is a pullingi shabdaha, so the answer is chatvarah. Let's see one more question. Gramasya samipe dash nadyau vahatah. The number given in the bracket is 2 and it is the visheshanam of the word nadyau. Students, if you are thinking that the answer is dwau as it is rhyming with the word nadyau, then let me tell you it is wrong. Because nadyau is the feminine form of the word. It is a strilingi shabdah, so the answer is dwe. Let me take you to one more question. Vatikayam dash narikel vrukshaha vartante. The sankhya given in the bracket is 36. It is the visheshanam of the word narikel vrukshaha. But as I have told you earlier, 5 onwards, all the number names have similar forms in all the 3 genders. So we don't have to think about the gender of the Visheshana Padam athava Vishesha Padam. The more important thing here is the spelling of the word. We need to choose the option with correct spelling. And the answer is the option 1, Shat Trimshat. Did you think of the same option? Good. Let's try to solve one more question. Shibire dash janaha sahabhaginaha abhavan. We are supposed to use the proper form of the sankhya 44. It is the visheshanam of the word janaha, but the gender of the visheshana padam will remain the same in all the 3 genders. So we need to choose the option with correct spelling. And the answer is Chatushchatvarimshat. I hope you thought of the same option.
That brings us to the end of the presentation. We will meet again with a new topic. Dhanyavadaha. Punarmilamaha.